With the Gemini API, you can now get the full transcript of every public YouTube video. That's interesting, because instead of watching hours and hours of content about a specific topic, you could now simply create a little workflow that allows you to paste the URLs of the videos you're interested in, and then just let AI get the transcript, and then also let AI create a summary about the core content in these different videos. We built this workflow with N8N. It's a workflow automation tool that allows you to create your custom automation workflows very easy by drag and drop via so-called nodes, where each node represents a step in your workflow. The final workflow will look like this. So we have a form submission node, a node that initiates the workflow. This node opens a default integrated N8N form where we can paste URLs of videos we are interested in. So in my case, I found 1, 2, 3 videos about GPT-5. We enter the video URLs, submit the form, and now the workflow is running. So we basically submit the form, get the individual URLs, transform the data a bit to make it easier to send to our Gemini API, which happens here in this HTTP request. The Gemini API could also do the summary already, but I want to split this. I want to use the Gemini API to get the transcript of the videos and then the OpenAI API to create the actual summary. Finally, we get our summary, convert it to a file, which is required here in N8N, and then upload a text file with the summarized content to Dropbox. So we get a text file with the core topics discussed in these different videos. To start the workflow, we add our trigger node. The trigger node in this case is a form, and whenever this form is sent, we will initiate our workflow. The form is pretty straightforward. We can add a form title here, enter YouTube video URLs, and then we add a form element, which we'll name video URLs, and the element type is a text area, as we want to paste multiple URLs. This is a required field, and with this, we can execute our first node already. This now opens this form element, and you can now paste any video URLs of your choice. As mentioned, for this workflow, the videos should be about the same topic, otherwise it doesn't make too much sense what we are building here. We then submit our form. So now we get our output. We have the video URLs submitted successfully, but of course we have one URL after another. And to process this information, we need to get each individual URL. So we have to clean this data a bit. For such operations, we typically use the edit fields node. I want to use a manual mapping. I'll just add a name like URLs, and this will be an array now with the following code. You can write this on your own. If you know how this works, you can also ask ChatGPT to do this. It's quite straightforward. And the result after executing this second node will be our 3 different URLs separately listed here inside our URLs array. But whilst the array is nice as a first step to have the individual URLs, to make sure we can send each URL separately to our Gemini API, we have to split out these individual URLs to process each URL step by step later on. This also brings us to the next node. This node is called split out, so we can turn a list inside items into separate items. We can simply drag our full list from the input area to our fields to split out field. Now we got 3 items. We only see one here, but if we check out the JSON view, we see we have the 3 individual URLs, but now as 3 different items, which will allow us to send each URL separately to our API. One thing before we do that though, here we have URLs, and I want to rename this to URL only. That's just a cosmetical thing here. I'll use the added fields node, which I'll map manually by adding a field video URL and enter my URLs expression down here. Now we have video URL here as our field, which is more appropriate. Now we can already send our HTTP request to the Gemini API. There is no Gemini node in n8n, so we use the HTTP request node here. If you check the official documentation, you can find all the actual content we need, all the actual code we need to send the request correctly. So it is a post request. We have to add our API key. So we can implement this step by step, set the method to post, paste the URL. We'll set authentication to none, but instead send the headers. And in here, we now add the fields we saw in the official documentation. So content type first, then we add a second parameter, which is our API key. And to get a key, you can go to Google AI Studio to the API key section, and there you can create your own API key to be able to interact with the API. Now we have to send the body. So we change it to using JSON and now enter some JSON code. So it's contents with the parts. Here I have my prompt integrated, and down here under file data, we just add our URL. So you can just drag and drop it into here. We can now execute the step. And now n8n will automatically send all the URLs to the Gemini API and hopefully return the transcript for each individual video. We get back three items. And if we check the first one, we get the text. I've been using the new ChatGPT 5 for the last few days. Now, as a next step, I want to aggregate the three different items, so the text we returned, the transcripts, to one single text that we can then send to OpenAI's API to create the summary. So we take aggregate node, where we simply take our text expression as input field name. And now once this node is executed, we get back the three different transcripts all together in one text field. So now we add our OpenAI API to create the summary. So OpenAI, message a model. Now here you also need a credential to work with the API. So you need an OpenAI account to get your API key on this page here. I set this up already. Now we can choose a model from the list here. Here we can now add a user, an assistant, and a system prompt. I'll just go with the user prompt and add this text here. Just to show you this, this is basically what I'm adding here. Here I have some details about the output. So I want to have a JSON output with the title and the content, because we can use this title later to give our text file a matching name. I also activate output content as JSON to make sure that this structure with content and title is created correctly. Now we can send this request to the OpenAI API, and we get our summary. Title is GPT-5 reality check. Here we have an executive summary at the top. So sounds nice. That's the preview of our text. I only want to save this summary as a text file on my Dropbox. Now for this, I have to add one step before we do the savings part. And this is a conversion. That's the convert to file node, which converts our JSON data to binary data. So we convert to text file. The text input field is simply our content. Here we can define the field name of the output data. I'll keep it unchanged here and simply run this step. Now we get our file. This means we add one final node, and that's the Dropbox node, where we select the upload a file feature. And as you can imagine, once again, to use the Dropbox API, you have to create an app, which then also holds the required credentials to interact with the Dropbox API. So once you set your credentials, you can turn on the binary file option down here. This name here must be equal to the file we created in the convert to file node. And here you can add your file path on your Dropbox folder. I'll use summaries/. And now I'll go to the OpenAI node once again, and there take the title that we added, because this will now be my name of the file, .txt. So we create a text file. And now when we execute this final step, we got another text file in our folder. This was the one we created before when I showed you the full workflow. And that's the one we created right now when we built that whole workflow. Now, of course, you can further tailor this. You can make this shorter by just using Gemini. But that's just how you can use such workflows and such APIs to make your YouTube consumption a bit more efficient. Now, if that's the right way to go for the future when it comes to watch time, clicks, ad revenue, etc. for the creators, I'm not sure, but this is possible already, so you can try it.